He knows that the tongue does great things, does righteous things. هو الذي يتلو القرآن. Your tongue does recite Quran. And it may also be a tongue, يذكر الله, that remembers Allah. And your tongue may call to Allah. ومن أحسن قولا من من دعا إلى الله. And who is better in speaking in speech than a person who calls to the path of Allah. But let us today focus as a reminder to Wallahi myself, before any of you, of the dangers of the tongue. The most dangerous thing the tongue can do is to call people, or to believe, or to call people to the belief of shirk, or the belief of kufr, to repeat the words of kufr, to say the words of shirk. This is why, as we see, for a person to enter into al-Islam, what does he say? Kalima. One statement. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. One statement. You enter into Islam. And it is also والعياذ بالله just that simple to leave Islam. To say a word of disbelief, may Allah save us ourselves and you from this evil end. What did Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم say? عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وهذا حديث متفق عليه agreed upon حديث إن العبد the رسول صلى الله عليه وسلم is speaking he's saying إن العبد سيتكلم بالكلمة بالكلمة من رضوان الله لا يلقي لها بالا فيرفعها الله بها درجات وإن العبد لا يتكلم بالكلمة بالكلمة من سخط الله لا يلقي لها بالا فيهوى بها في النار. إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون. The Rasul says, the servant of Allah may say a single word from the pleasure of Allah that will please Allah and he will never think that he has said something great. He will never think that this is a word that will raise him many levels. And at the same time, the servant of Allah may say a single word. A single word from the displeasure of Allah that will displease Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Allah will sink it with him into the fire. Allah will sink him with just this one word into the fire. This is one of the most evil things the tongue can do. Another example. What else can the tongue do? The tongue may lie. يكذب. Especially على الله ورسوله. It is worse to lie obviously against Allah or His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah says in Surah Al-Zumr, verse number 60, وَيَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ تَرَى الَّذِينَ كَذَبُوا عَلَى اللَّهِ وُجُوهُهُمْ مُسْوَدَّةً أَلَيْسَ فِي جَهَنَّمْ مَثْوًا لِلْمُتَكَبِّرِينَ And surely on the day of resurrection, on the day of Qiyamah, you will see those people who used to lie against or about Allah. Their faces will be darkened from embarrassment. Is there not in hell, in Jahannam, a fitting place for these people who are arrogant? وقال النبي المصطفى صلى الله عليه وسلم من كذب علي متعمدا فليتبوأ مقعده من النار رواه البخاري Whoever lies about me intentionally, knowing, let him be ready to accept a seat in the fire. وعن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم آية المنافق ثلاث إذا حدث كذب وإذا عاهد أخلف وإذا اؤتمن خان The sign of the hypocrite is three. This is a hadith agreed upon, متفق عليه. If he speaks, he lies. He lies. And if he promises to do something, he does not fulfill the promise. And if he is entrusted with an amana, he betrays the trust. وقال صلى الله عليه وسلم من حديث أبي ابن مسعود رضي الله عنه متفق عليه أيضا and agreed upon حديث also إن الصدق يهدي إلى البر وإن البر يهدي إلى الجنة وإن العبد لا يصدق ويتحرى الصدق حتى يكتب عند الله صديقا وإن الكذب يهدي إلى الفجور وإن الفجور يهدي إلى النار وإن الرجل لا يكذب ويتحرى الكذب حتى يكتب عند الله كذابا والعياذ بالله. The Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم says, truthfulness, being truthful, leads to righteousness. If you are truthful, you will be righteous. And righteousness, al-birr, leads to the Jannah. and the person may seek the word of truth. And he will always try to seek truth until Allah will write him amongst those who are truthful. Allahu Akbar. And at the same time, lying leads to disobedience, and disobedience leads to the fire. And the person may lie, and he will always keep on lying until Allah, wal-ayyadu billah, will write him amongst those who are liars. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. The hadith muttafaqun alayh. What are some of the other actions of the tongue? Shahadatu zur. Witnessing false testimony. Being a false witness. في الصحيحين عن أبي بكرة رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ألا أنبئكم بأكبر الكبائر ألا أنبئكم بأكبر الكبائر ألا أنبئكم بأكبر الكبائر قلنا بلى يا رسول الله قال الإشراك بالله وعقوق الوالدين فكان متكئا فجلس وقال ألا وشهادة الزور ألا وقول الزور ألا وشهادة الزور ألا وقول الزور فكاد يرددها حتى قالت الصحابة ليته سكت صلى الله عليه وسلم. في الصحيحين in both authentic books Bukhari and Muslim from the hadith of Abi Bakr رضي الله عنه it is stated to us that the Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم was sitting with the Sahaba and said should I not tell you of the biggest of the big sins? Should I not tell you of the greatest of the great sins? Should I not tell you of the biggest of the big sins? He said, what is it, Ya Rasulullah? Tell us, Ya Rasulullah. He told them to take partners in worship with Allah and to be disobedient or disrespectful or undutiful to your parents. And he was lying down at that moment, so he sat up and he told them, also, being a witness of falsehood, or testifying falsely, being a witness of falsehood, or testifying falsely, and he kept on saying it, until the Sahaba said, he has emphasized it so much, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we wish he would leave us. We wish he would remain silent. He has made his point so clear. Shahadat al-Zur, ya ibadallah, from the biggest of the big sins. What else? What other evil things can the tongue do? Al-Ghibah. Al-Ghibah. أتدرون ما الغيبة? Do you know what ghibah is? عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أتدرون ما الغيبة? قلنا الله ورسوله أعلم قال ذكرك أخاك بما يكره قلنا يا رسول الله أفإن كان في أخي ما أقول قال إن كان فيه فقد استفت وإن لم يكن فيه فقد بحثت رواه مسلم وأحمد In the authentic hadith, the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked the Sahaba, do you know what ghibah is? They said, what is it, Ya Rasulullah? Allah and His Messenger know better.